church. They were praising the Lord. I just came from a Mennonite church. They were praising the Lord. I just came from a turned-on church. They were praising the Lord.
He just wants to reach down and touch it and say, you know what? No more. No more. You just lay that down right here. You know, I was thinking about that whole casting all our cares upon Him because He cares for us today too. And there's so much in this world that we ourselves think that we can take care of. We try to do something, and especially for the fellas in the house. The fellas in the house, you know, we fix everything. That's why we're going to fix it one way or the other. But the problem is, there's certain things that we can't fix. There's certain things in our lives that we can't fix. And we got to take that stuff to Him and lay it down and leave it alone. Cast all of our cares upon Him because He cares for us. Think about that for a minute. He didn't say, just bring me all the big stuff. He said, everything in your life, bring it to me. Cast all of your cares upon me. That's a beautiful thing to know that I have a God who created a whole universe. And more to go with it that I probably will never ever see or care to even know about, right? Amen. And He said, cast all of your cares on me because I care about you. Mm-hmm. Think about that. My goodness, what a mighty God we serve. He's outstanding. That just makes me feel all good to know that my God, the creator of the universe, that holds the world in the palm of His hand, tells me, poor little old helpless redneck me, cast all your cares upon me. That's right. Every one of them.
Uh-huh. Amen.
But like I said, us fellows, we got a tendency to think, I can fix that. I'll take care of that. I'll get that done. I'll get that. I can handle that. And then we get about halfway into it. We're like, oh, Lord, there's a few nuts and bolts and screws missing from here. And I don't know what to do anymore. Right? So if we went to Him first, we never had to worry about them nuts and bolts and screws that had already been fixed before we got to Him. That's the God that we serve. But nonetheless, has anybody got any prayer requests or prayer supports this evening they want to share? Go ahead, Brother Andy.
For my mom's work, pray for all them who work that money with all the
kids. Yeah.
And today the away.
Ooh.
To find a new home for them.
Right. Right on. Definitely. Yes. Definitely keep them in prayer. A few other things. Let's keep our kids, our youth of this nation, and not just this nation, but the youth of this world. Let's keep them lifted in prayer. A couple of the schools around about us, they've had some. I don't want to give too much publicity and make this thing sound like it blew up, but there's a couple of kids that have ended up catching corona and such of that nature. You tested positive in that, so let's keep it lifted in prayer, you know, and along with that, you know, they keep saying that we, as a state, we're growing too and having more tests positive and things of that nature, but you know, I'm going to tell you, just like we've said from the beginning of this, since this thing started, if my God can stay the hand of death, He surely can stop coronavirus right dead in its tracks, right? If He can stop the hand of death right dead in its tracks, coronavirus don't stand a chance against that. And those people who are called by His name, if we humble ourselves and reach out to Him, right, He will hear us and He'll heal our land. But He starts with us humbling ourselves. So let's keep them kids lifted in prayer. Let's keep this coronavirus, whatever they call it, an outbreak, but I just think it's the devil picking and poking, you know what I'm saying? He's trying to get us all scared again because we've overcome, because we are overcomers, right? We've overcome and we understand that God has this under control.
Yes. Amen.
God has never been this under control. And the thing is, the devil thinks if he can scare more God's people,
come on,
and get us that fearful, right? You know,
amen,
if he can get us scared because, oh, we can't go outside, we're going to catch that nonsense. Well, my God's stronger, my God's mightier than that. I believe my God's going to keep His hand upon me, and no matter what, I don't have to worry about it. Anybody else got any prayer requests, praise boards?
Songs are so amazing because everybody has a song that's special to them.
Yes.
And they're singing those songs, so they're sharing their heart and their testimony. So tonight is a popcorn service. You feel led to share a testimony. You know, even that small little story you share can touch you don't even
Amen.
Know. Like a little dandelion seed, it just right. carries and carries.
Amen. Amen.
So I want to share reasons to praise the Lord.
Amen.
Yeah. He is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Yes.
He is the Alpha and Omega, the first and the last,
yeah,
the beginning and the end. He is the Prince of Peace. He is the Great I Am. He heals the broken heart. brokenhearted.
Amen.
If anybody's brokenhearted tonight,
Amen.
He can heal your heart. These altars are always open, and we're here to pray for you, too. He is your healer, rescues you from your enemies, sets you high upon a rock, comforts you in all your trouble, gives you an abundant harvest, restores what the enemy has stolen,
Amen.
Delivers you from evil, rescues you from every trap, and this is pastors, he says this one a lot, he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. Defender, provider, full of mercy, God of justice, never changes, makes all things new.
Mm-hmm.
My favorite, he calls you friend.
Yay.
And he's your savior, perfecter of your faith, gives you the desires of your heart, and wants to give you exceeding abundantly above all you could hope or imagine. Praise the Lord. And every one of those is from the Bible.
Praise the Lord.
The ultimate of that is to be in heaven with him. So I'm on my way to heaven.
Amen.
I'm on my way to heaven, my journey gets sweeter every day. I'm walking with Jesus, I'm talking with Jesus along the way. My soul gets so happy, I shout and I sing both night and day. I'm on my way to heaven, my journey.
very glad to be here today. We're going to have a good time.
Amen.
How you love us, and oh, how you love us.
Anybody else have a song or testimony? Don't hesitate. Come right on up here.
The Yeppers.
All right. We'll go to the end.
Because his word and faith is my sword and shield. Amen. Jesus is Lord of the way I feel. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Indeed.
So if you watch Serena, she's going to show you.
Daddy?
Well, praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Nobody loves you. Nobody wants anything to do with you. You're worthless. But you know what? Praise God. The Lord finds us worthy through Him. Worthy enough to die on a cross, to suffer pain that we just cannot imagine. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. And I'm thankful because the Lord delivered me completely from manic depression. And I remember there was a time when I didn't want to wake up the next morning. I just wanted to die so bad. But aren't you glad that what we wish and what we want isn't what God wants? And He knows the plans that He has for us, even today. You know, praise God. And I'm just so thankful to be part of this big family of God. And I wasn't going to sing much tonight, but now I feel this is on my heart. Praise the Lord.
you sing that Lord about this?
Yes. I don't need the lyrics for that. I know this.
I'm switching it.
E minor. It's just E minor. E minor. E minor. G. I love this song. I'm glad I went to a watery grave. That person that I couldn't stand, I used to always say myself hates, like I, myself hated me. Well, I didn't like myself too much either, and I'm thankful that one day I went down to a watery grave, and I came back a different person, somebody who could smile and be happy about things, praise God.
In my house there's been a pussy killing. I used to be a thing crucified. And the death of this man is a final way of grieving. In a spiritual way to live, I hate to die. If I let this dead man linger.
God kept his hand on me, even though I wasn't serving him, he was still protecting me because of the prayers of his children, you know. And finally, I surrendered, and I gave my life to the Lord, and I spent a lot of years singing in the bar rooms out in the world, and I want to spend a whole lot more years in the church houses singing for the Lord.
God is good. let us down. You know what I'm talking about. At the very first sign of trouble, there's nowhere to be found. Well, Jesus stays when others go. He'll never leave your side. He's your friend in stormy weather, 'cause he's good all the time. God is good, yes he is. He's good all the time. God is good, yes you know he is. He's good all the time. You can search the whole world over, no greater friend you'll find. He's not good just once in a while, he's good all the time. Well, he's the one you call in the middle of the night when your body moans with pain. Don't worry about that wayward child, 'cause he's heard you call his name. He'll put food in your kitchen when you don't have a dime. He's not good just now and then, he's good all the time. God is good, yes he is. He's good all the time. God is good, yes you know he is. He's good all the time.
Favorite song.
Oh, yes.
And you know, that's gonna be a wonderful day too when we finally go home and get to be home with our King Jesus.
Amen.
And we get to be up there singing with them saints up there, all those ones that went on before us.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, they're singing with them. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise God.
This world's coming to an end and it won't be long. The party's gonna start and go on and on and on. And I'll be singing with the saints at the morning light, bringing in the day 'cause there is no night. Saying goodbye to the heartache, trouble and pain. I'll be sitting at the throne with an angel band, shouting hallelujah to the great I am. If you think it's a dream, well it ain't. Well, I'll be singing with the saints. The tambourine's ringing and David starts to feel the rhythm. Paul and Silas are humming a tune they wrote in prison. Well, Gabriel hears the music and he picks up his horn. Just another glory, hallelujah, more. And I'll be singing with
the saints at the morning light. Bringing in the day, cause there is no night. Saying goodbye to the heartache, trouble, and pain. I'll be sitting at the throne with an angel band, shouting hallelujah to the great I am. If you think it's a dream, well it ain't. I'll be singing with the saints. Cause there is no night. Saying goodbye to the heartache, trouble, and pain. I'll be sitting at the throne with an angel band, shouting hallelujah to the great I am. If you think it's a dream, well it ain't. Well I'll be singing with the saints at the morning light, ringing in the day, cause there is no night. Saying goodbye to the heartache, trouble.
All that I should, and all is well.
to God, glory to God. Anybody else got a song here, a testimony? Anybody want to share a testimony right quick?
I'm going up.
He's making his way up. What a wonderful testimony.
Amen.
That's the truth, isn't it?
Yes.
But the song that Doug's singing with the saints, and I'm the aunt, that's always what that song's like. But 3 years ago, Heaven gained an angel, which was one of our sisters. And she had such strong faith. But I'll tell you what, she's made it home, and she's singing with the saints.
Amen.
And that song was played. Doug didn't sing it at her funeral, but it was played at her funeral, and all of her siblings, which there's only 16 of us. And we gathered around, plus then some, we gathered around her coffin at the funeral, and we rejoice at that song because she is singing with the saints. I think Roger set this song up real good. It's called Prayer is the Key to Heaven, but Faith Unlocks the Door.
We're almost home. This home that I'm waiting is worth my
No sickness, no suffering, there is no more strife. Built by the mighty carpenter from the city of Galilee. Well, I have a feeling that my mansion will overlook the crystal sea. Well, as soon as I get there, I'm gonna find my family. Gonna talk a while with the one who laid his life down for you and me. As for walls, gates of pearl, the things that are in store, I'll wake up in that promised land to live to die for you. Song for the redeemed. The crowd is so excited, it'll be more than a dream. Well, you might find me running up and down those streets of gold. And in my friendly body,
where the map is strong and cold.
It's called Come Morning. It's really been great with you tonight. God's children too long have been burdened. They are longing for heaven's bright shore, where heartaches are left far behind them, and burdens are carried no more. Evergreen trees.
Sometimes I'm despised and rejected. Then I question, oh Father, how long? But I'll take one more look at Mount Calvary, and it gives me all that strength to go on. Yes, sing that again. Come for me, by the river.
Confused about tomorrow and who holds tomorrow. I am here to tell you, saith the Lord, that I am here, that I am here. I am here, saith the Lord, and I have tomorrow in the palm of my hand, saith the Lord. Yea, I would say unto thee, those that are confused and has fear in their lives, I would say unto thee, do not be concerned about tomorrow. Do not even look down into next week, saith the Lord, for I am in your future. Do not look behind you, because you can't change anything from behind you, saith the Lord. And my children, I would say unto thee, it is now time for you to come out from amongst the world, saith the Lord, that you totally separate yourself from all those things that are not of me, saith the Lord. I desire to use you. I desire to use you, saith the Lord. And I would say unto thee, come unto me. Come unto me. Come unto me, and I shall open up the door. doors for you that no man can close, saith the Lord.
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
you're doing in our lives. But we just thank you for showing up here, Father God. And who are we, Lord, but just a handful of people that you've set apart for your purpose. Lord, we just thank you for the move of your Holy Ghost in this building.
God gave me three verses for you tonight. Out of Psalms 34, chapter 34, verse 17, says, "The righteous cry, and the Lord heareth, and delivereth them out of all their troubles. The Lord is nigh unto them of broken heart, and saveth such of the contrite spirit. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivereth him out of them all." As Pastor Rocky said earlier, we try to fix things that we cannot fix. And he said the righteous cry and he hears them. You say, "Pastor, I don't even feel righteous." Let me tell you something. I'm not righteous either. My righteousness is filthy rags, the Bible says. But it's Jesus' blood that washes over me and makes me righteous. So when I cry out to God, when I tell him all my troubles, woo, he hears them all. And he's there to deliver them. He said not just some of our troubles, Pastor Rock. He said all our troubles.
Amen. Come on now.
So I'm here to tell you tonight, if you got troubles, hold on. Wait a little bit longer. Deliverance is coming. Because Jesus said, "I shall deliver you out of all your troubles." Not just some of them. Afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord is the one who delivers them from them all. See, if I can fix all my problems, how would the Lord get the glory? I'm here to tell you, when God fixes my problem, he gets the glory. Hallelujah. You got troubles tonight, you need to bring them to this altar, because God will deliver you. Hallelujah.
Woo.